Finally today, do you remember the Sons and Daughters concert? Remember the big showcase and the immense talent? The big gig that kicked off the UK City of Culture year, it was televised and all that, so some night. Well, now it's the turn of the Sons and Daughters art exhibition. It's launched in the Millennium Forum only this evening. The general manager of the Forum, Paul Mason, has been given our Michael O'Donnell a wee pre-launch tour where he came up against some familiar faces.
It actually came a little bit indirectly through both Facebook and Radio Foyle. We, as you know, last year ran the Undiscovered series where we brought artists from all over the city who maybe hadn't had the opportunity to show their work. And we wanted people to really have a platform in the Forum that they would be seen by the multitudes and the masses, where people wouldn't necessarily want to go to a gallery space. And what happened was, I noticed on Facebook that this guy, Oliver McParland, had done a wonderful portrait of your very own, the late Gerry Anderson. And, you know, I've searched for a long time to get a portrait artist that I wanted to put an exhibition on, and it just seemed to tie in really, really well for us. So after a little bit of foraging through Facebook and contacting Amanda, actually up in the news office, I got in touch with Oliver and said, look, I'm really keen to do something. Have you any other paintings? He says, cripes, he says, I've a house full of them. So he came to meet me, and this is the result. And I have to say, I'm absolutely delighted that his work is just, I mean, every image captivates almost the soul of the person that he's trying to represent and his work, which is just fantastic.
I would just start here at the very beginning, and we have just a wonderful depiction of Gerry Anderson here. And beside him, one of Sean Coyle, as you say, sort of gets the essence of the two men.
It really does. I mean, the smiling faces, you can see the mischief in the eyes. And even, you can almost imagine now, look, like Sean's laughing at Gerry at something he said. You know, and so, yeah, I mean, they really do captivate just the very essence of the partnership. And then, I mean, when you move on, you look at what we try to do in particular with this is that we've looked particularly at Northern Ireland, but we've also looked, I suppose, closer at Sons and Daughters, if you like, of Derry and the Philly.
Yeah, so, kind of a reflection on the concert that was here that launched the whole City of Culture 2 years ago. Yeah.
Absolutely. So, I mean, you can see now that we've got this fabulous portrait of Dana singing her wee heart out, and of course, none other than Nadine Coyle, who, again, you know, one of the fabulous daughters of Derry.
So all is that they recognise it as well. And I don't want to feed anybody's ego here, but I see a soul sign beside Sean Coyle already, and a soul sign beside Gerry Anderson.
I wouldn't be surprised if Sean Coyle bought that himself, you know, just so he can look at himself a bit more, maybe.
Perhaps not. Perhaps not, but yeah.
That's not for me to say, but I think you're right.
Yeah, probably. But, I mean, again, he is selling them. And the idea is, look, we don't expect to sell out of all these paintings, but what we certainly want to do is, over the next, you know, this exhibition is going to run for 6 weeks. We will probably have somewhere in the region of about 20,000 people through our doors over the next 6 weeks at a variety of concerts, from Do You Come Here Often Tonight right through to the middle of February when we've Tommy Tiernan. So this is something that, I mean, everybody will know these people. So, if, I mean, Oliver himself would be the first to say, look, he would never have the opportunity to exhibit the 20,000 people. This also engages the 20,000 people when they come through our doors, that they're not necessarily sitting looking at the walls or looking at their tickets waiting to go into the show.
It's a great focal point, isn't it? For it's pretty attentive. That's when you walk in the corner. Absolutely. Who else we have here? There's Fergal Shirky.
Instantly recognisable again, and I mean Phil Coulter, Roma Downey, and the fabulous Amanda Burton from television. I mean, again, they're all instantly recognisable, but again, they all seem to captivate the artists themselves. It's not just, you know, a painting of somebody. This actually does say a little bit about them and how they are. Yeah, it's fascinating stuff, and it really is very inspiring for us.
And all the people we've had so far are from the city here, from the Northwest. And now we're going to somebody who probably wishes he was from this area.
Of course he does.
That young McElroy, the golfer.
Yes, and if he played golf in any way like me, he would, you know, he'd be even happier, I'm sure. You know, these are just too fabulous. And the close-up shot of Rory and the intensity in his face is just fabulous. But if I could replicate that swing that he's got in the large canvas, I would be a very happy man, and my handicap wouldn't be in the double figures the way it is.
If you didn't know anything about Rory McElroy, you would know those guys can play golf. Just by the
absolutely.
Stats. That's a big the perfect follow-through, it looks like he has.
It really is an outstanding piece. And again, it's a great side, you know. That, I mean, these things will... I mean, I'd love to see if we could have got Rory here. It would have been fabulous. But, of course, you know, he's obviously in sunnier climes out in Dubai practicing, where I'm stuck here in the green gloomy weather.
He would already be in Dubai than here.
I heard him.
That's why he's not from here.
Yeah.
That's why we're not from here.
So, again, here we are now with Liam Neeson. You know, and again, that you can always see that gaunt look that he has, and you can near hear him saying those fabulous lines, "I will find you." You know, I mean, that image again is just it's wonderful, absolutely wonderful.
And a little surprise here too, with a couple of Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah, I
mean, the glitter goddess, the couple there.
Mm-hmm. So again, then we stepped away a little bit from the sons and daughters thing, and this is Oliver really trying to show some of the variety of works that he can do. You know, I mean, he's done the Glitter Goddess one, which is a really great way, a great medium that he's done on the glitter on canvas. The bottom painting is just, I mean, because of the colours that he's used there, you can almost see the torment that's going on in Marilyn's mind as he's looking. But, you know, I think that's an outstanding work.
Yeah, this looks like the reality behind the starter, doesn't it? It's all the colours running down her face. It looks like mascara could be running. It's a blue colour thing, and you can see the pain in her eyes, the pained expression on her face.
It's two sides, doesn't it? Yeah. I mean, the glitter, and that outward look, the Hollywood star, and then maybe the terror that's behind it.
Maybe say the top one is Marilyn Monroe, the bottom one is Norma Jean Baker.
Absolutely.
It's quite childlike as well in its own.
Yeah.
In its own way.
So, again, here's another woman that wishes she was from the fabulous city here, Philomena Begley. But again, instantly recognisable. No, instantly recognisable. And again, you can, I mean, if you've met Philomena, it's just her. Yeah. And absolutely captivates you. So, yeah, really.
She was only the wee twinkle in her. And a rider, and there's a sporting contest to a few of these as well, too.
Yeah, so these are ones that they've done, and they've done some of these, you know, I suppose over a period of times. And again, you know, look at the spaghetti hoops, which is a can of hoops, he's called this, which is fantastic. It's basically spaghetti hoops.
But the Celtic colours.
Celtic colours.
I wonder, is this a homage to Celtic or a homage to Andy Warhol?
A bit of both, I'm sure of. You know, and again, a great, just a nice, fun piece to look at. The one thing about this is, from my point of view, is that the pieces of work that we want to show are pieces of work that everybody can enjoy. You know, it's really important that art engages people, but it's also equally important that people sort of understand that. You know, we can put on pieces of work that maybe people think, well, that's a yellow splodge and a blue bit of paint. I could do that. These are things that people will instantly go, my goodness, you know, the talent is instantly recognisable there from Oliver, that he can carry some of these off.
And so walk on through the corridor here we have.
Yeah, so we've done a couple here. These are, if you can see what that is.
He's measure,
yeah. Isn't it? I mean, that's just...
That's the Joker in the Batman movie, which he made, I think, just before he died. It was just probably his last movie,
But these are a couple that are totally out of context, but I thought we should, you know, whenever we were chatting to Oliver, we thought we would try and do a couple of things that weren't necessarily with the run-of-the-mill of the rest of the exhibition, and they're going to be cited in a slightly different place, but again, they're really engaging photos. So this is a biblical scene.
The loaves and the fishes?
Yeah, absolutely, the 5,000. And I mean, the perspective in the print and the fact that you can almost sense the huge crowd that are going away in the distance. Yeah, I think that's an outstanding piece again.
Yeah, it's wonderful the way that the figures kind of just blur a wee bit the further back you go, and you wouldn't recognise them as actual people until you bring it forward again.
Yeah, absolutely. There's an interesting piece in this, and it's something I want to talk to Oliver about because I want to understand what it is. But this one piece, and there's one ghostly figure in the middle of the painting.
Is it a pencil drawing or a chalk drawing?
And it's done deliberately. It's done there for that one person to be standing out from the rest of the crowd. And it'll be an interesting one. And I suppose anybody that's visiting, let's see if they find that.
Yeah, it'll be John the Baptist, maybe something. And I think that's all. And of course, no, the dairy is complete without.
No, absolutely. Absolutely, and again, the Bloody Sunday, and again, you'll see then that there's the 13 roses. You see the shots and the white flowers are done there because of the symbol of peace. So,
and red signifying the blood as well, which is also dripping off the sign thing.
Absolutely, and again, then that handprint is to symbolise the blood in the hands. So yeah, I mean, a really, really powerful piece. And when we look at what's happening around the world even now with these the cartoonists in France, you know, you can instantly see that, you know, art plays such a large part in world politics.
And finally, we have four well-known local faces here.
Yes, so this is us back again to the Sons of Derry, and I suppose a reference to our history in the political sphere. So we have, and no exhibition will be complete without, of course, the wonderful Gregory Campbell, but we have John Hume, Martin McGuinness, Eamon McCann, and of course Gregory there as well, adorning the wall. So we would hope that that will appease everyone that comes to look at the exhibition, that we have everybody is represented here as well.
When is it start? How long is it here for, and when can people see it?
Launches tonight, and we're here every day, 7 days a week, and it's on running for 6 weeks. So everybody's more than welcome. Just drop in, or if you're coming to show, we have a visitor's book, so we really want people to engage with this, leave us some comments. And of course, the paintings are for sale, and Oliver is an artist, and as such, would require some funding. So yeah, great.
Michael O'Donnell reporting from the Millennium Forum there, Sons and Daughters on the telly tonight, film